Hi, I'm Peter.
I'm Rydia.
And we wanted to talk to you about pelvic pain when you're pregnant. It's really something that is not really addressed a lot.
No, and in fact I find that there's a lot of women that just think it's part and parcel of the whole thing.
There are things you can do that can minimise the pain. So, keep your legs together.
Yes.
It kind of got you in this position in the first place.
Yeah, yeah.
But keep your legs together. Think of yourself as a princess getting in and out of the car.
Yeah, that's really good. In and out of bed. Rolling over onto your side to sit up first, not swinging one leg out.
Now, these are the best two things. Don't vacuum.
Yes, any loading of one leg.
Pushing and shopping trolleys are hideous. So get your shopping delivered, get your partner to do the vacuuming. Yep. Standing on one leg.
Which often you do without even thinking about it.
More weight on one leg, sheer force through your
pelvis. Crossing legs.
Mm. Walking on soft sand can be really uncomfortable
because
your pelvis is moving. Heels.
Yes, although I could never get away with heels during pregnancy.
Yeah. So if you are having pain when you're exercising your pelvis, it is the wrong exercise for you. Yeah. You need to find an alternative. And you need to see someone. That's what physios are there for, or an osteo, or whoever your preferred practitioner is.
Yeah. And certainly after pregnancy, you know, you don't want to be getting pelvic pain when you're getting back into exercise.
No, and it has been reported that between 7 and 20% of women have pelvic pain after pregnancy. So don't expect it just to go away like that.
Yeah, it's going to take time. But if you're doing something and it's aggravating it, you need to stop. And if it's there all the time and it's not getting better, see a health professional.
So this is the one time that we fully, fully support belts and strapping.
Yeah.
You need to get a belt on you as soon as possible. The earlier you get it on, the better.